Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. It's Paulie, Esther here, and today we had level 4 of the archives drop for Tome 2, the Reckoning Tome. So let's read the news. New content, Archives Tome 2, level 4. Level 4 of Tome 2 is now available. Reach the epilogue node for the ultra-rare iridescent Primus coin charm. Level 4 brings the following below. 23 challenges, including 10 master challenges, 11 memory and log entries, and more blood points. To access level 4, you must have reached the epilogue node of level 3 with either role. Please note that the rift for Tome 2 will close on April 1st at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. The below will also take effect as of this date, April 1st. Challenges, entries, and blood points from Tome 2 will remain available permanently after this date, but they will no longer award rift fragments. Once the next tome begins, Tome 2 will be available in the compendium section. Player level XP will stop awarding rift fragments, and unclaimed rewards from the rift will be automatically claimed on your next launch of the game or tally screen, whichever comes first. Community outfits from the free track of the rift will enter the in-game store upon release of Chapter 16 for purchase in iridescent shards. Okay, so this is talking about the Mr. Puddles elephant clown outfit and the Demon Slayer Fung Min. Those were the outfits that were designed by the community. They're going to be on the in-game store upon release of Chapter 16 for purchase in iridescent shards. So Chapter 16, that's going to be about 3 months away. If you don't know what those outfits are, they're talking about the Demon Slayer Fung Min. Yes, that is how you say her name. I know I had somebody comment to me, it triggers me every time you say Fung Min because I'm a Fung Min main. And I'm like, well, if you're a Fung Min main, then you should really look into the pronunciation of her name. And you should be one of the people who is championing for the correct pronunciation of her name. I can cite my sources if you don't believe me. Anyway, I digress. Now, we go over here to... That's the Demon Slayer Fung Min, and we go over here to Mr. Puddles for the Elephant Clown outfit. Those were the two community-designed outfits. These are going to be available in the store once Chapter 16 comes out, and you can buy these with iridescent shards if you were not able to earn them in the Rift. So, let's go ahead and check out these archives. So it's saying that once this closes, Tome 2 will be in this spot here in the compendium, and you'll be able to revisit any of the challenges that you didn't complete for the blood points and the memory logs. You just won't be able to get any rift fragments, but just like Tome 1 Awakening is here, that you can revisit it if there's something you didn't do, Tome 2 will shift into this after April 1st. So it says we have 22 days left for this. Here's level 4. You have to have completed the path and reached the epilogue of level 3 to access level 4. So some of you may not have done that yet, so let's go ahead and look at some of these challenges. So we have a straight shot right down the middle to reach the end here if you want to get the epilogue. So let's see what we got. Gruesome killer challenge, hook 30 survivors. That's going to take some time, but it's doable. Iridescent Age, earn 15 emblems of iridescent quality, okay. Doctor's Orders, kill all survivors in a trial one time by any means. Complete this challenge in a single trial. Well, I should hope so. I'm only going to half kill them this game, and I'll half kill the survivor the next game. Anyway. Bloody Rewards, earn 100,000 blood points, okay. And then that's your epilogue. So 1, 2, 3, 4 things to do, and you're boom at the end. Not bad. Now, we have a lot of side quests here. Let's look at the survivor-sided ones here at the top. Drop a pallet to stun the killer 5 times. Easy. Succeed at 5 consecutive skill checks in a single trial. Not bad. Easy. Fall from a great height while being chased 4 times. All right, so you might want to put in a map offering while doing that one so that you have a lot of drops. Take 10 protection hits, not bad. That doesn't have to be done in one game, so it's easy. Escape 2 trials through the hatch, okay. So I'm assuming if you brought a key that would work. Earn 3 benevolent emblems of iridescent quality or better, okay. Heal a total of 8 health states of any survivor. take two protection hits as David King in a single trial. Unhook four survivors. You must unhook them safely, complete this challenge in a single trial as savior. That might prove challenging, but it's not impossible. Jane's victory, stun the killer three times as Jane Romero, complete this challenge in a single trial. It's like this challenge was written for Nilarama. Three stuns in a single trial. Now remember, it doesn't have to be head-on. You can stun in a variety of manners. Head-on collision, stun the killer by exiting a locker with head-on one time. Speaking of head-on. All right, and then we have one more survivor here. Repair 12 generators to bring the light. Okay, so those are your survivor challenges. Now we have down here deadly pursuit, chase survivors for a total of 300 seconds. See, I like that most of these don't have to be done in one game, and the ones that do aren't bad. So I think that they learned from the first tome, and these are much easier. They might be time consuming, but they're doable. Close the hatch two times, okay? Earn three malicious emblems of iridescent quality or better. Okie dokie. Rin's sins, kill all survivors in a trial one time by any means as the spirit. Okay. Does the sacrifice count as kill, or are we talking about mooring here? Haunted hit. Hit a survivor with your weapon while that survivor is exposed one time while using Hex Haunted Ground. I like that one. Crushing dominance. Knock down eight survivors. Complete this challenge in a single trial. And then escape two chases. Oh, this is another survivor one. Escape two chases in a single trial. So it looks like there's more survivor challenges than killer ones here. Let's see. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13. This is either or. Yeah, so there's only 2, 4, 6. There's only 8 versus 13. 8 killer challenges versus 13, if I'm reading that right. And then there's your Primus coin. I've seen this already. So I think this little hourglass bit here, whirls on the charm, we're going to have another moving part like we did for the blinky eye on Tome 1. And let's see, what do we have here? That's going to be 8. 11, 14, 33, 43, 46, 54, 57, 60, 58, 71, 76, 79, 89? I don't know. I might have missed that. It looks like there's 89 fragments here. So just the fragments alone, completing these are going to get you almost 9 tiers. And then you get the 10 for completing the whole thing. So there's 10 tiers worth of fragments right here. Not including, you know, what you're going to earn for the experience points on top of that. So there's a lot of fragments here. Now, I'm done. My rift is already at 70. I'm finished it. So the fragments don't mean anything to me because I can't get them. I can't bank them for my next level, my next tome. All I'm getting are the memory logs and the bonus blood points. The fragments don't mean anything to me because I'm done. But I'm going to do this anyway. So because I want all of these memory logs. I love the lore. And then once this rift closes, I'll be reviewing some of the storylines from the lore here after the fact. But I'm going to wait until the rift actually closes to talk about any of the storylines in there. All right, so this is open now. Go get your, do your grind, get your rift on. Unlock those free cosmetics. And if you're in that paid track, try and get all of the cosmetics down there too to reach tier 70. That's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching. Oh, you know what else I wanted to see here? Dark Devotee outfit. I forget what I think I was getting ready for PAX. So I never did look at this outfit here for the plague. Desperate to cure herself, the High Priestess followed forbidden practices. Partake in the cult with the plague's dark devotee outfit, featuring the Crown of Despair, soiled robe, and beeswax sensor weapon. Wow. What is going on with her skin? Oh my god, is this maggots and larva? Holy cow. Is that supposed to be larva moving on her body? Oh my word. Tell me about it. All right, the high priestess' flesh was covered with swollen abscesses. Desperate for a cure, she followed the forbidden practices of a forgotten dark cult, the cult of anguish. Crown of Despair. Her crown of spikes showed her adherence to the dark cult's most fervent methods, namely impaling the sick. Soiled robe. She bathed in gruesome mixtures of squirming worms, dead flies, and clay. It's maggots. She was desperate to find a cure. She's maggoty. Oh my god, this is disgusting. And cool. Okay. And the beeswax censer. Filled with moist larvae and mushed bee eggs, her censer casted distinct nauseating fumes. Mushed bee eggs, you say, huh? Beeswax censer and bee eggs, huh? Bees, you say, huh? All right. Anyway. Go get your rift on. Have a great day, everybody. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.